Nick Holden's going to reverse his field. Alex Tuck is next.
Whoa, is it me?
Yeah, Holden's stick is stuck in the glass. That's one you don't see every day.
It's Kuzi's stick that was cut. No, it isn't. Now, Kuzi's got Holden's stick.
Can you do that?
I don't know if you can
or not. I'm not sure if
you
can do that.
I think that's a penalty. It's a penalty, Joe. You nailed it. You can't grab another opposition stick and use it. And it's not even the right shot, I don't think.
No, it is.
It is the right shot.
Well, if it's Holden's stick originally.
Washington minor
penalty. Wow, that was weird.
Equipment. Yeah, it was. So he went over the stick. Here's Holden in the corner. Now his stick's caught between the stanchions. Now, Kuzi also dropped his stick on the ice. Instead of grabbing his own, he grabs Holden. And he says, hey, wait a second, that's not my stick.
He knows it's not.
No, but had he dropped it there, Joe, he knew right then. But had he dropped it, they would have given him the benefit of the doubt. But once he played it, he's in the box.
Yeah, good backside pressure there. Tarasenko flew coming back.
Oh, now Preko lost his stick. That could be problematic. He can't get it. It's in the corner. And now Barry drops it off to Rantanen. To Barry. What a save by Jake Allen. And now Tarasenko hands Preko his left-handed stick.
Uh-oh.
And now Barry gets it. Into Rantanen. For MacKinnon. And Tarasenko can't do much there without a stick. Rantanen goes for a skate. Here he comes. Chased by Tarasenko. Now play back to Tyson Barry. Now MacKinnon in front to Rantanen. And a diving play. And the Blues break it up. And we get a whistle. And a penalty has been called.
He went, what happened here is Preko grabs Tarasenko's stick. Tarasenko then went and grabbed Pareko's stick. If the referee thinks it's a broken stick, we're full of rules here, JK. And you were right on in the last one when it went off referee Tim Peel. Colton Preko just came back and told the bench that Tarasenko is not allowed to go back and grab his stick.
Illegal equipment.
Illegal equipment is what they call it. When you get a guy like Larry Robinson confused and Craig Berube confused, then this is a confusing matter. So the stick comes off. And so that stick's not a broken stick. So now Tarasenko goes over and takes the left-handed stick of Colton Preko.
Well, I have never seen that.
I haven't either.
So
the bench was
equipment.
Yelling for Tarasenko, John, to say, go grab his stick. Go grab it. So no one aware of that rule.
And a power play in overtime for the Avalanche. It will be a 4-on-3 advantage.
Back for the puck is Morgan Rielly. Tim Peel with his arm in the air is calling a penalty. Looks like maybe one each way.
Oh, he gave him the warning and yeah. Oh my gosh, right in the middle of play, he called it. You don't see that very often. Usually it's right after the play has ended, but here, as Mike Babcock's gonna complain, you've got the first penalty.
I think everybody wondered what the penalty was because there's no signal for that. But Winnipeg goes to the power play on Wednesday Night Hockey. Season's officially on. Mike Babcock's raging at referee Tim Peel over an equipment violation penalty to Leo Komarov.
Well, it's a little too late now as the whistle had already gone. What's really interesting, Jim, is that we mentioned earlier that he had got the warning from Peel, and here's where it comes from the exhibition season where you see all last year he basically wore it up. Now he is grandfathered in. If he does take it off, he's allowed to go without a visor because he had played the minimum amount of games before.
Works it free and makes a play to Mark Giordano.
Ice!
Call that icing, a bounce past Spurgeon, and we'll get a face off at the other end.
Mobil 1 Extended Performance. Go 25,000 kilometers between oil changes.
And that's second line for Minnesota with Charlie Coyle, Nina Ryder, and Zach Parise. We didn't see much of them in this hockey game, but their last two shifts, they've had some high-quality scoring chances on the Flames.
The stall line out there right now. And some confusion over... They're going to call Calgary for a delay of game penalty.
Calgary, delay of game, bench minor.
It was an icing call on the Flames, and there was some confusion over who was supposed to be on the ice, and then...
Sean Monahan goes down to tie his skate, and I think that's what they're calling.
Was it that so much, Cassie, or was it not having the right guys come on the ice quickly enough after the icing call? Because you see the official over at the bench.
Yeah, I don't know. There's Sean Monahan tying his skate. And, yeah, I think it's the back linesman who kind of comes in and talks to the ref. I think that's what the call is.
Well, you don't see that every game.
Irwin puts it towards the net. Blocked by Klefbom. It dribbles through. It's still loose. Shot by Sissons. Covered. Koskinen without his stick. As it comes back to Weber. Yarnbrook without his helmet. And there is Koskinen out to play it. And that's going to be a penalty against Mikko Koskinen. With 3:02 to go in regulation time. A delay of game penalty against the Oilers goalie.
He's going to no stick. He's a little bit of a panic because he knows he doesn't have it. I don't think he was out that far from the blue paint covering that puck up. He came back, was almost going to play it, and it was whistled down for a delay of game penalty. He didn't like it very much, but it's a power play for Nashville late in this game with a 2-2 tie.
It is the fourth power play of the game for the Nashville Predators.
Lindholm turned it over. Marner lost it. Grant will get it, and he'll fire it over the glass and out of play. That'll be a delay of game penalty.
You don't see that too often, do you?
Coach doesn't like it either.
NHL number 38, minor penalty delay again.
I mean, this puck isn't even rolling.
Well, there's times in practice.
It's unbelievable.
You practice this sometimes for fun, and you can't even do it sometimes when you try.
And the Leafs 4-for-8 the last three games on the power play. It's been red hot, so this doesn't help Anaheim's cause at all at the moment.
Not giving up on it. Kicks it ahead. Nudibara to play. He'll lift it up. And Carolina trying to lay the body here on the Blue Jackets, who fight it off, but icing the call.
Well, Marcus Nudivara just iced the puck, which is fine here defensively. But he makes this a smart play here on Williams. Williams knows he's not going to beat him with speed. He tries to turn up on him. Nudivara stays right in his hip pocket and actually pushes him down on the ice. Allows all of his teammates to get back. What's happening here? His lace is cut. They're saying he has to stay on the ice. But he's got a problem with his skate. Columbus is getting a bench minor here.
We'll step aside as this one is sorted out. The Jackets irate, and rightfully so.
Placing the lace of Marcus Nudivara's skate, and it was an icing play. Nudivara was instructed to stay on the ice. He had an equipment issue. He went off. A new player came out, and the refs didn't. They had enough of it, so they gave the Blue Jackets a bench minor penalty. I don't think they knew that he had a skate problem, or they would have probably let him change.
Shot deflected off Bobrovsky and out of play. First power play for Carolina. They come in 22nd in the league.
Crosby, Hornquist, and the back pass went the other way as Lundqvist went out of the crease.
Yeah, it was McDonough that came back, who was slow to get up.
Lundqvist's stick is in the corner. Shot went wide. Lundqvist hasn't been able to go out to get it. Back the other way. The shot goes up. Lundqvist knocked the net off. You can hear the fan reaction.
Wow, what a series of events here in Pittsburgh. Here's the odd man rush first by Pittsburgh. And you see McDonough coming back and looks up, and there was Lundqvist, who was out of his net. Lundqvist might have gotten hurt on this play. There you see it. He goes down hard. That's a heavy collision. He loses his stick. And there was the end of a shift. And Lundqvist wanted a whistle and didn't get it. So he does this. And that's a penalty. That's a delay of game penalty. And so he was incensed at the ref for not blowing the whistle. I don't think it was the referee's fault, though, Sam. I mean, I don't know if they knew that he was hurt on the play or if he was hurt.